are you doing?
Moving money to a lot. Wedding.
Cool. Who's wedding?
My cousin's.
Cool.
There you go. All right, this is KMS 10 at 10. If you've joined before, you know exactly what we're doing. If you haven't, we are talking about digital marketing updates for this last week. We go live every Friday at 10 a.m. You join me and the fabulous Luke here to talk about marketing.
I am pretty fabulous.
So my topics today are going to be instant videos on Facebook Messenger and Snapchat.
I'm going to talk about a little bit about YouTube and their censorship, and then also an update to Google. Google Merchant Center and the Google Shopping ads.
Nice.
Don't forget, if you have any questions, comment below, and we'll try to get to them during the show, or if not, we'll get them after. Or use the hashtag on social media, KMS10at10.
A-T, not the sign.
Yes.
And exciting news, I guess we just got a Snapchat account.
Oh, we did.
So if you want to follow us for more tips and tricks and crazy office shenanigans, we're at Key Media.
Yeah, let's just that up. Key Media. Join the party late, but hey, better late than never.
Yeah. Also, next week we're going to have a special guest. If you saw about 2 months ago, Chris was on, one of our sales guys. He was on here, and he's going to be on here next week to talk about the mobile training event that we will be having on September 28th. So that's 26 days away. If you haven't signed up yet, you need to sign up right now. We will post that link in the comments again, as we've done in the past. Cool. Well, then let's get started.
Let's talk about stuff. So recently, YouTube... they didn't necessarily announce, but they started actually doing something about advertising-friendly videos on YouTube. For those that don't know, if you put out a YouTube video, you have the ability to monetize that video where they'll show ads before, during, or after, and you'll be able to make money for that. You won't make all the money that they get from those clicks or views, but you get some of it. They have recently kind of clamped down on these certain videos that aren't advertising friendly. So if you have any videos such that have any sexual content, violence, language, drugs, or controversial or sensitive subjects such as war or tragedies, you might not be able to monetize your video. YouTube content creators are upset at this because this is really hindering of what they can, you know, promote or put out. And then, like, the things such as war or tragedies, like, how are we... I mean, there might be just the basic news channels that, you know, how are you going to report on the, you know, the Orlando shooting?
Yeah.
If you're just saying what the facts were. Like, you weren't saying that it's... that you are one way or the other on what happened, but just for not saying that, and they're not going to let you do that.
Yeah.
So, people are upset because it's really closing... Like, I mean, obviously, it's YouTube's website, but freedom of speech. It's like, you can't say what you want to say.
Yeah. I know. I think both ways on this is, like, they're restricting it and not allowing people the freedom to post whatever they want, but they're also cleaning it up, which is needed as well, because there has been a lot lately of just kind of getting out of control with negative material on not only YouTube, but Facebook and Periscope, Twitter. And so I think it's just cleaning it up to make things a little more peaceful.
Yeah. So. Question for our viewers. Do any of you subscribe to any YouTube channels, or comment below what your favorite YouTube channel is? Other than the Key Media Solutions YouTube channel.
Yeah, everybody's.
They watch us all the time, so.
Cool. So our next topic is instant videos. And if you haven't heard about this yet, that is because it's a new feature in Facebook Messenger. And if you notice, like, Facebook Messenger is really trying to become very user-friendly to help out people to communicate with customer services and businesses and to request Ubers or to order food. Now they have this instant videos, which is actually video calling. So like FaceTime. It looks exactly like FaceTime. It's a feature that will pop up in the right corner of your Messenger app. And the only thing is that both users would need to have the latest version of Messenger in order to use it. So you can, if I was messaging you and I would say I was, their example they use is that they're in an ice cream shop and I'm messaging you and I'm like, oh, Luke, what flavor do you want? I can pop up the video and show the menu board. And then you reply, you're like, I want strawberry. And then you can also...
Cookie dough.
Yeah, you can also, well, in the example, I'm just following the example. So then you say, I want cookie dough. And then I'm like, well, how many scoops do you want? I'm just messaging you. And then you actually, like, call me back. You open up the video, the instant video. And now we're video chatting while we're messaging. So both show up. And so it's just another way for Messenger to help out users to get that other feature of communication. What do you think?
Yeah, nothing new.
Nope.
But, I mean, put it all in one spot. Facebook's Messenger app is getting better and better every day, bringing in new features. Yeah. I know people were upset when they broke it off from the main app, but
I can almost trying to take over your phone so that you only go to Facebook or Messenger when you open up. So, but yeah, I think it's an awesome tool that will help with communication. Of, like I said, if we're messaging and you're like, oh my gosh, I don't want to like text anymore, I'm just going to call you and figure this out. Ice cream is a big deal, and it's kind of hard to figure out, so I guess you would need a call.
All right, my next topic is Google recently did an update to their Google Merchant Center. This has to deal with Google Shopping Ads. For those who don't know, Google Shopping Ad is when you're searching something on Google, and you just search blue shirt. Google will then show ads for blue shirts, and you actually will see an image of a blue shirt, and you'll be taken to a website where you can purchase a blue shirt. They update with a new interface. They made change so you can make changes to the feed. The feed is where you go and enter in your products. You can make changes to the feed without having to edit it directly. It just less steps to in order to change things up.
Yeah.
It was kind of funny. The blog I was reading, they call Google Merchant Center, Google Shopping, the neglected stepchild of Google products.
Yeah, it kind of is.
So.
I've actually, though, have you ever used like the shopping section and looked through the products that pull up? I do quite often. It just like kind of pulls in. I think it's a nice feature that pulls in multiple sites into one area.
So
you can kind of compare prices easier.
So. Yeah, it's really similar to search ads because it's keywords and, I mean, there's a quality score and you have to set your... have to have relevant ads in order to show. So
nice. So our last topic of the day is Snapchat. If you weren't here at the beginning of the episode, we just got a Snapchat account. So, but on to other things about Snapchat is they just released, if you know about their geo filters, that was an access that was allowed to for anybody to use, but you kind of had to build your own graphics, go to the website, upload them. It was almost a little extensive for users to have to build their own graphics if you're not used to Photoshop or Illustrator or any of those image building softwares. Now they actually have templates, customizable text, and colors. And the templates, some of their top topics are birthday, celebrations, and weddings. So you can go onto the website, mess around with what they already have set up, and build your own geofilter. Geofilters start at $5 and go up from, depending on the size of the area you want to target and the duration you want to run it for. But $5 is pretty cheap for a geofilter. And the geofilters, if you guys aren't as familiar with Snapchat, is when you take a picture and then you scan, and there's a few, like, I know Sioux Falls has them, and, like, major areas have those filters that pull across when you're in a certain location. So you can build your own.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm definitely going to look into that. I'm getting married next
next
summer, so I want to have something for our wedding. Our great contest specialist Sam wrote a blog actually about Snapchat filters because he got married not too long ago. Whole thing about how you need to set it up, what you need to do. Great.
And did quite a few blog. People use your geofilter? They did.
Okay. He shook his head yes.
So people do use them. I think they're pretty cool. I use Snapchat quite a bit. I know a lot of my friends do. I know it kind of varies. Like, some people don't use it often. Just preference of what platforms you want to use. But people do use those geofilters, and they do catch on, especially if you're using them for an event, a birthday. Your birthday's coming up. Or a celebration. So I know weddings are pretty big. All right, well, that's all we had today. If you have any questions on the topics we talked about, if you're watching this later and you have a question, feel free to throw that in the comments section or tweet at us at hashtag KMS10@10. We're always here to answer your questions, always willing. Also, we wanted to point out that for our mobile training event on September 28th, seating is very limited. We're getting very full. I think we're almost to capacity. So if you do want to join us, which I know you do, you better sign up now or you won't get a spot. Like I said, that link will be posted in the comments.
Yes, and then also another link in the comments is our YouTube channel. Sam's just killing it behind the scenes. It's in the comments of the Facebook video. So, yeah, check that out.
Well, right on. That's all we had today. So, thanks for joining.
Have a great Labor Day.
Get on a boat.
I'll be on a boat, not a boat.
No, I won't either. Yeah.